Hi, this is Manos Bourlakis from the Minneapolis Heart Institute and the Cardiovascular Innovations Foundation, presenting case 56 for the Manual of Percutaneous Coronary Interventions. This is a case illustrating some of the core principles of assessing coronary anatomy. The patient was an elderly woman who presented with unstable angina. She underwent diagnostic angiography using radial axis that demonstrated no significant disease in the left main as well as the LAD. And there was a high-grade lesion in the proximal into mid-right coronary artery that appeared to be the culprit lesion. So in this case, it would appear natural as the next step to perform PCI of the right coronary artery lesion. However, if we take some more time to revisit the images, this patient has a very long left main, and there is no vessel supplying the lateral wall of the heart. There is actually no visible circumflex. And that's one of the key core principles of coronary angiography. One has to identify the coronary artery supplying its myocardial territory. And in this case, the artery supplying the lateral wall is not visible. We did a non-selective injection on the right sinus of Valsalva, and that does demonstrate a vessel coming off, which is likely an anomalous circumflex. And using a multipurpose catheter, we were able to see that there is an anomalous circumflex originating from the right sinus of Valsalva below the origin of the right coronary artery. And not only that, but it seems to have a high-grade lesion in the proximal segment, which seemed to be the reason why we had difficulty engaging the vessel. Had we not done this imaging and just ended the right coronary artery, we would have missed another potential culprit for the patient's symptoms. Having an anomalous circumflex coming from the right coronary artery or the sinus of Valsalva is the second most common coronary anomaly after the separate ostia of the LAD and the circumflex, and it's usually benign. In this particular case, we decided to treat both lesions. We started with the right coronary artery lesion, as we do in most radial PCIs down to the right coronary artery. We used an unplugged AL1 guide catheter that helped us deliver through the Shepher's crook right coronary artery without any difficulty and obtain a nice result. And then we used a multipurpose guide catheter to engage the anomalous circumflex. We administered 100 micrograms of nitroglycerin, and to our surprise, the patient actually did not have any significant ostial lesion. All we were seeing before was actually spasm from attempts to engage this anomalous coronary artery. So the concept here is that not only one has to account for all myocardial territories, but also nitroglycerin is very important to be given before diagnostic angiography to avoid misinterpreting spasm as fixed coronary lesion and doing potentially unnecessary stenting. So in summary, there are two key concepts for coronary angiography. One is that all myocardial territories should have their coronary flow identified. And in cases where there's a long left main, anomalous circumflex is often the answer. The second is nitroglycerin should be given in every angiogram if possible, unless the patient, for example, has very severe hypotension, to exclude any spasm that can be misinterpreted as fixed coronary lesion. And finally, using an unplugged guide catheter can facilitate the performance of right coronary artery PCI using radial access as it provides strong support. Thank you.